Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
What's that?
It's a wall. It's a door.
No, it's a bench.
No, it's not.
Push it.
Push it.
Push it.
We just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there.
Tried. Begged.
quickly. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth. Look how much it's changed.
The same, but feels different. an imposter world where the forest itself is watching. Another gate.
Another gate? You know what to do. Stay back. Don't open it. It's not safe. Don't listen to them. Listen. Don't open it.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
What does it mean?
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see them?
Ravens.
I hear something.
If you hear the song of Valravn, follow it, and it will lead you to him. But be aware of his illusions. You can't always trust your eyes.
Who make it back are forever changed.
Hey. She can get up now.
She can get up now. What's happening? She can get up now.
How can she get out?
It must be magic.
Dark magic.
A trick. Valravan.
Tricking her.
Valravan.
How can she get out?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
Valravan's magic. It's not him.
He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it
on her own.
He's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
We picture fear, and we think of a shadow in the woods. A creature in the night. If only it were that simple. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Valravan, he's there. She has to find another route.
Druth says there's always another route.
She find a way. Go round.
Find your own path.
There's a different way.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry, and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything, turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
The Northmen say that Odin is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir, who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own eye as offering to Mimir. He drank from the well, and traded one way of seeing for another.
Reminds her of something.
The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left him.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat the darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
The ravens.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Some are still there.
Ravens helping?
No, he's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. I can't think.
Out in the wild. In the cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. she remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.